Maria Kraus, who is from Germany, from some school I've never heard of, who's convinced me of all the reasons why I cannot hire her. That's all you can do? Oh, and she wants to be big in entertainment. Hi!
I'm really good and
at
I
what?
Should work for you at everything. I can
at
do everything.
Everything?
Yeah, right.
Like?
Media. Different types of...
Yeah.
I even play music.
Yeah, like
piano.
What instruments?
Yes. And I play the drums.
So if I take you to a piano right now, you could play it?
A little?
Ah! Chopsticks!
I mean, I stopped a while, but yeah, I'm still good.
Do you sing?
No, I
don't. So if I get you on stage tonight, you could play piano?
Not on stage.
Okay, forget the stage. Not yet. Not ready for the Hollywood debut with Chuck Wright from Quiet Riot.
Well, I work behind the scenes.
Oh, you're a behind the scenes kind of girl. I thought you said everything. Yeah, everything behind the scenes. She's everything behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Okay. Could you get that bucket of water over here?
Yep. Still going.
Yes, it's still going.
I thought first you were talking to someone or on the phone, and that's why.
I was.
Yeah, now I'm talking to us.
Yeah, I was talking to us. It's all about you. This is your job interview, so why would I want to hire you?
Well, I'm international, that's always a plus.
Yeah.
And I just finished my master thesis.
In what?
International Culture and Business Studies.
Yes. And what did you learn about international culture?
That they are different. And
it's all good! Yay! What a revelation. Whoa, stop the press. They're different. Yeah?
Well, that you should be careful and... I know how to speak to people from other countries.
Okay.
And it's always good to just know or to have an understanding for a different culture. Not American, it's like German, I think, a little. So yeah. I know that there are some things different, but I think it's harder to work with Indians or...
Indians science. From India or what? Indians from America?
From India.
I see. Do you know this from personal experience?
No, same. Well, I've been in Chinese.
I've done a lot of work in India, actually. I didn't think it was that difficult.
You didn't think it was difficult?
No, the work was easy. The people were difficult.
Yeah, that's what I mean. You first have to understand how they're working together. Functions.
I don't think they understand it yet.
Well, yeah, because they just do whatever they want and...
And then make up excuses why it didn't work right. You did it wrong, it was your fault. Oh, great, now you're telling me, a month later. Thank you. I could have fixed it had you said something earlier.
Well, better than never.
I guess.
But yeah.
So what do you want to do when you grow up? At the end of time, what will they remember Maria Kraus for?
For... being nice and living the dream in America, trying to live the dream in America, just being a little bit disappointed because I know it's difficult. But I didn't give up. I never said that I give up.
How old are you?
So I will write applications.
How old are you?
26.
Do you want to live in America? Or do you want to travel the world, be an international
traveled already. I didn't travel that much that you probably did, but I also traveled. So.
Well, so is your goal to be here in America or to work in America and travel the world?
I mean, yeah, you can do both.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can. Can you?
Yeah, of course. Why not?
I don't know. Maybe you have things tying you down.
No.
No.
No, I've never been like that.
Never been tied down?
No.
They will never tie me down.
No, I always. Look for different things in different countries.
Good.
Yeah, like I said, I just handed in my thesis, and one day after this, I flew to LA again.
Oh. It keeps calling you here. Then make the move. What do you need to make the move?
A job.
A job.
I mean, yeah, maybe that's because I'm German that I think, it's better to have something when I come here. And. Just the safety that I really can do something here.
Do you have a car to drive?
I mean, I would have a car.
Because I was going to say, how would you get to work?
By bus.
Oh, that sounds like fun. Why are you late? The bus was late again. Oh, okay.
No, actually, they're really on time. Today I was really surprised.
Well, that's good.
I mean, if I can come by bus to Santa Monica, then I'm able to come here by car as well.
I guess so. Wow. Or wherever.
Yeah.
How soon can you start?
What kind of start?
Work. That kind of stuff.
Yeah.
How soon could you start?
I could start today.
Today?
Yeah. I mean, last week I had nothing to do and I was dying. I need something to do. I like to work, so.
Okay. Interesting. And how are your computer skills?
Yeah, it depends. So social networking is maybe not the thing, but yeah, I work with other programs. I know how to work with Microsoft and with Adobe programs.
You know Adobe Suite?
Yeah.
So you know how to edit?
So different kinds of programs. So Photoshop, Illustrator, Premiere. I worked with Dreamweaver as well, but it's a long time ago. But not After Effects. I didn't work with After Effects.
Is that something you want to learn?
Yeah.
We have all of that.
I know, I love it. I would love to work with all of these programs because it's always cool to create something with them and yeah.
Interesting. Well, we could do a trial and see how we work together.
Yeah.
And if that works out, then we got to figure out what paperwork would have to be done. Because you'd have to get a work visa here.
But I mean, so what would you plan to, or what would be my position then? What I would do?
Everything.
Okay.
Yeah, you said you can do everything. I want to see you do everything. Yeah.
No, but that's good. I mean, the more I learn, if I can do...
I scaled down my company dramatically over the last year because we had a lot of employee theft.
Yeah.
And cyber theft and electronic theft and other stuff. It's been a nightmare. And so I'm regrouping and looking for new people I can trust. Because we do a lot of high-level work with governments, with businesses all around the world, and I can't have stuff leaking like we did last year. We had stuff get totally compromised. I mean, I've got the federal government involved. I've got major companies that I may be suing over it. It's been a fucking mess. It's turned my life upside down. And so it's almost like starting over. I got to rebuild business back up because everything has been put on the wayside where I've been dealing with this other stuff and rebuild. And I'm also in discussions with people in Istanbul and India and other countries about going there to finish films.
Yeah.
So while I may start here, if you're serious about sticking with it, we may be relocating temporarily to those other regions to shoot and complete some other films that I'm working on. So that's why I asked if you could travel.
Yeah, of course. Like I said, when I studied in America.
The position I would envision for you is personal assistant. So you're doing everything from scheduling appointments to booking appearances, handling money issues. Are you good with money?
Yeah, that's the thing. I'm not. I didn't study something with the how to do this, controlling stuff like that.
Right.
But I think if you show me once, then that should be no problem.
Well, every situation is different, and you may get the information from them and say, let me get back to you, and then we discuss it,
yeah.
And then I go, here's what I want for this, and then you get back and finalize the arrangements. I mean, it's not brain surgery.
But I mean, if I first get the idea about it,
right.
Better than I...
Because I'm booking a lot of voice work, where if you keep me booked in the studio, we can put down $10,000 a week, but
yeah.
We really got to stay on and follow up with people, follow up on emails, phone calls.
Yeah.
But you're getting to learn a lot about the business at the same time.
So how many people work for you right now?
I have a bunch of independent contractors.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we've got about 80 of them working right now. We've had many more. but it's on project basis.
Yeah.
But I've also had, at any time in the past, I've had 3 to 4 or 5 full-time people working just with me to manage all the stuff going on, because I do so much. And that's where I scaled all those people back, because I had them stealing. I was like, what? So...
What did they steal then?
Money, contacts, all kinds of stuff.
Okay.
It's cost us millions, literally. So...
What did you do then with them? I mean...
People get greedy. And they see ways to steal and make money.
Yeah, true. But you fired them, but you couldn't do that to pay a fee or something back, or did you sue them?
What?
I mean, they stole, and
yes.
So you have to sue them, or...
Will I sue them at some point? Not today. Okay, now I want to rebuild the company. I worry about suing them after another film or two is out, and I can hire a bunch of attorneys and say, go take care of this problem. Right now, I need to take care of other problems, like keep the lights on,
yeah.
Keep business going, things like that. But it could be a... Wow, that's a squeaky dog. It could be a win-win situation. It gets you a job, and it helps get me back in the right direction. And if it works out well for both of us, then we turn it into a more permanent thing.
Like that idea?
Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Right.
I mean, it's a better job offer than you've had last week.
Totally. Yeah, but the thing is, you don't have an office here or something.
I work out of my house over in Glendale, Pasadena area.
Yeah.
When I'm in town. I haven't been in my house in like 3 months, and it's probably a mess inside because I haven't been there for months, and before I left, somebody had broken in and made a mess, so now I'm going to come back and clean up a mess and get started again. So over the next couple of weeks, I'm going to be getting the house cleaned up, getting the lights turned back on, getting everything current, and want to hit the ground running in the next week or so. If you can help clean up the house too, it's messy, then that can be part of the work.
I'm fine with cleaning. That's what I did as well.
I've got a 3-bedroom house. If you put in a long night and you need a place to stay, there's an extra bedroom you can crash.
Well, I help you cleaning, and then we can start
exactly.
Working.
I even have a big organic garden. If you like to grow things, there's plenty of organic garden to grow things in. Do you grow things?
Yeah.
I have like 27 different berries growing, and jasmine, and lavender.
Yeah.
It's all organic in the garden. I like organic gardens. Fresh vegetables. Fresh things, yes.
But there's one thing. Well, I will fly back to Germany again at the beginning of August, because I couldn't find something here. So, and I wanted to apply from Germany to come back then. But if we say that I could just come back then and start working, I mean, the
Why do you even have to go back?
Because I didn't have a job.
You can always extend the return.
And I mean, I have some festivals as well in Germany.
Oh, now that you do that. But I have some partying to do first.
No, it's only in August. And yeah, they're the huge...
How long in August?
Until the end of August.
Oh, so you wouldn't even start until September?
Well, I could do something until the 4th of August.
Yeah.
And then I also could work from Germany. I mean...
That you could maybe do.
Yeah, see?
I just saw you. I'm disappearing. I'm gone now.
No. I'm not like that.
I started working. Goodbye now. I'm on vacation for a month. I'm on holiday for another month. Oh, my God. I want a job in September. Not now. Now's
no,
too
no,
soon.
No.
I'm not ready. I have parties to go to first. Listen to you. Maybe I should come to the parties. Are they good?
Well, these are festivals and bands play there. It's like... I went to one.
Well, we have bands who play here all summer long, even in August.
Right, but there play 20 or 30 bands at one.
Yeah, we have those too. It's called Lollapalooza.
I heard about it.
Yeah, okay, so.
Well, yeah, but didn't book something for LA, so. I mean, like I said, I could work from Germany as well. If you are traveling all the time, then we also are in contact via Skype, email, or whatever.
Yeah, so you get back in time, and then I'll go, oh, now we're moving to Europe. Oh, can I start in another month? I want to party in America first.
Yeah. No.
You are funny.
But I mean it. I really mean it.
I mean it. You're really funny. You're cute. You're funny.
No, but I really mean it with the working.
Okay. She's serious about the working.
Is it still recording?
I don't know. It looks like it might be. Is that okay?
Fine, yeah.
Okay, fine, sure. What the fuck? When will I get to hear you sing?
No, there is no singing.
When will I get to hear you play?
After a while. I need to practice singing.
I can walk you to a piano right now. Go to the piano and start playing.
Do you have a piano at home? Or?
No, I wish I did. I know where I can go find pianos whenever I need one.
Where?
Studios or hotels, or I'll just go find one and break out and start playing.
Yeah, but I really have to get into it again.
Yeah, I mean, somebody might be listening.
Yeah, see?
God forbid. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that.
But I like to play things like, I don't know if you know him, Ludovico Einaudi.
No, but I'm willing to hear.
Yeah, he's really good.
Yeah.
He did the soundtrack from The Untouchables.
Oh. Okay.
I think The Untouchables, I'm not sure.
I think, but I'm not certain. Let me Google it first.
No, I'm not that Google person.
You're not?
I mean, now I have.
Now I am. I really know Google well. What do you need? Let me Google it. You're funny.
If my Indian boyfriend would see that I smoke that much, he said I shouldn't smoke anymore, and so I'm just smoking when he's not there. It's really difficult for me, but...
You sure you need this boyfriend? Are you gonna hide so much stuff from him? Maybe you just need a different boyfriend. What do you think?
Well, it's good that I don't smoke that much.
Right, that's true. If you're around someone like me, you'd be smoking too much. Maybe you shouldn't take the job now.
No, that's fine.
No, it's fine. I'll smoke on the job. Just not around the boyfriend. I'll make sure to brush my teeth before I see him. You're so funny.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. What else will you be hiding from him soon? The other boyfriend. Okay, got it. That's so European of you.
If you work with so many music guys...
Then... Yeah, you gotta have a couple boyfriends. What the hell? You're funny.
Actually, I'm not that kind of... girl, so.
Which kind?
That has too many boyfriends.
How many is too many?
No, that has
six
more
or
than
seven?
One.
Oh, okay. One at a time. Have you always been a one-of-a-kind kind of girl?
Yeah, I'm really responsible.
Yeah. How old is your boyfriend?
37.
You like the older men?
Well, it's 11 years. It's fine.
Where's the cutoff?
Don't know. Can't say.
Is there a cutoff?
Depends on...
the chemistries?
Exactly.
I see. Okay. Do you have good chemistries with Indian boyfriend?
It's okay, yeah.
It's okay. It's not great, it's okay.
Oh, it's a different thing. I think that we are always like, well, yeah, fine.
Could it be better?
Yeah, if I would live here and would have a job.
Ah, that would make it better.
That would be one thing, yeah.
Well, why isn't he getting you a job then if he wants you here?
Yeah, he works for Ernst & Young.
He can't get you a job with them?
No.
Why?
Because they do stupid, boring things. And I said, no, I don't want to do it. I would like to do something in media and with music, I said.
They have media and music and clients.
Yeah, but no, it's...
But no,
they do.
No.
Yeah,
but no. But no.
That wouldn't be your job either. You wouldn't like that.
Oh, fuck no.
Yeah, see? And they would.
Because I have talent. What the fuck would I want to work with a bunch of pencil pushers for? That would make me crazy.
See? And that's what I don't want to do.
I hire them. Push these pencils, make sure it all adds up right. I want my share. Go back and re-add that. Make sure you added that right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my job. My job is not to sit there and count how many units there are. Fuck that. There are unit counters. Hire them.
Yeah, you did it right. That's the right decision.
I create.
Yeah.
I invent. I do things. I don't sit and wait for people to do it and then count how well they did. That's what I hire people for. You guys figure that out.
And why do you suggest me to work here?
Well, I just thought if he wanted you that bad, he could help get you a job.
But yeah, for me it's boring. I said, no, if I start working here, then I want to do something that I like.
Like leave. Leave this job quickly.
Yeah.
Before I get a gun and start shooting people.
Totally, you're...
I won't become homicidal. I won't become suicidal. Homicidal is possible, though, if you piss me off. Was I depressed? No, I was pretty fucking angry. You made me do this. Oh, God, that's funny.
So, yeah, no Ernest & Young, right?
Yeah, I can see why. I would only hire them to do the counting. I wouldn't hire them to hang with.
And even then, I don't know.
Because those guys don't even know how to fucking party. If you're going to party, you got to be around people who know how to do it.
Yeah, exactly. That's
amateurs really fuck it up.
And I thought it's so difficult to find someone who likes good music here. And I thought more people here like the... Do you want to put it in here?
No, I was going to let you have some.
No.
Oh, hell no! Hell to the no! I just met you. Last time I did it, somebody laced it with shit and I had crazy things happen. I woke up in a stranger's bed. And no, he was strange.
No, I didn't. I just was not there anymore.
Where did you go?
Yeah, I don't know. Mind left.
Well, I'll tell you what. We'll try it again today, and then we'll take pictures. So if you leave, I can show you where you went. We'll videotape, and then I'll say, remember this? It'll be like 51st dates. You'll be like, no. Who are you? Charlie, remember me? No, I'm high. Where am I? Tether me back down to Earth, please. Yes? Is that you? Okay, great. Thanks for the warning.
Yeah,
look at it, it's the Stay Puft Marshmallow Girl from Germany. She's way up there. She must be high. She's at 40,000 feet.
I've been there.
Yeah, what do you see from 40,000 feet?
Nothing.
You don't see like a lot of blue and shit down there?
Yeah, a little. The beach.
A little.
So the beach.
The beach.
Now I really would jump from 5,000 feet.
You jumped?
50,000, no, I don't know. Yeah,
no,
skydiving.
Not 50,000 feet.
5,000.
What, were you in a fucking rocket ship? She was with Elton John. She was Rocket Woman. Rocket Woman, yeah. Hell yeah. Rocket Woman. I'm going to take a camel. Rocket
Woman.
Because you're not supposed to smoke. Oh, now that's funny. Look at Turkish domestic blend.
This.
And I told you that I was going to Turkey. In fact, this morning I talked with my friend at NBC in Turkey.
Mm-hmm.
I do a lot of work with them. And he has studios there. And we're talking about using some of the same people who worked on Mission Impossible 5 and Mission Impossible, the last couple of Mission Impossibles that were shot in India and Turkey. And Taken, Liam Neeson films, some of those same production people who work on our films.
Right.
If we're going to do it, got to do it right. Correct? Is this not correct?
So impressive what you're just saying.
Well,
all the things.
Now let me freak you out even further. Are you ready? Is he dug
I'm
in his
sure
pants?
I'm not sure if I'm ready.
Has he dug deeply into his pants? You saw my press ID.
Yeah.
Driver's license.
Mm-hmm. But there's nothing special, right?
Then well, it will make more sense later.
Okay.
Cannabis card.
Okay.
And it says, the bearer of this passport is also known as?
Mm-hmm.
Also known as. Also known as.
So,
see, I have multiple signatures. And it says, see that page. And I have multiple names. I'm this person in India.
Really?
Yeah, this is in my India work visa to work in India.
And why did you have to change your name then?
And here's Turkish visas.
But for what do you need to change your name?
I did it for me. To protect the innocent.
That they don't recognize you or? What do you mean?
If I'm traveling under a different identity, they may go, you look like, but
yeah.
I have a whole different name. Different credit cards and...
Okay, and as your assistant, do I get other names as well?
We could arrange for that if you would like. Would you like them?
Well, of course.
Okay, we can arrange for this.
I mean, it's so difficult to say Kraus.
To what?
To say my last name.
Kraus? Not for me, it's not Kraus.
Yeah, for you, because you worked international, but...
Well, I worked international my entire life.
Yeah, see?
So I understand international business rather well, thank you very much. I might be a good teacher. You might learn something.
You speak other languages?
Pig Latin. No.
Pig Latin?
No, I don't. I can speak Jai. You want me to ask me something? I can talk to you in Jai.
Well.
Okay. How many languages do you speak?
German, English, a little Spanish, a little French.
The Federale is a pinch and pedal.
There was no Spanish and no what?
Yeah, that was Spanish. The Federale is a pinch and pedal.
What? No.
Federale is a pinch and pedal. Fucking dog.
Okay.
Pinching is fucking.
Okay.
You didn't teach you that in Spanish?
No.
No fucking
in
Spanish.
I've been for 6 months in Spain, but yeah.
No fucking in Spain. Okay, got it. No pinching. Hi. Do you speak Spanish?
No.
Just curious.
You almost have to in order to live in L.A.
Well, where are you from?
San Francisco.
Well, but you live here?
Yeah.
Well, you got away with it. Damn, good for you.
Because you almost have to speak Spanish.
She's German and she wants to move here. Should she do it or run like hell?
What's going on in Europe versus what's going on in the United States? I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. Damn, nowhere safe.
Did you know that Germany just got attacked?
When?
Yesterday.
Where?
I
didn't hear about this.
They had a terrorist attack yesterday, I think it was.
In an airport or where?
No.
Do you mean in a train station or something?
No.
I just read the train station thing.
I don't remember. Maybe it was this morning. I was just saying yesterday, well, you know, all the refugees, and I said, well, the Germans not going to put up with any of that terrorist shit. Sure enough.
Okay.
And it happened this morning?
What?
I'm looking right now. I didn't know anything about it.
No, me neither. I just heard that there was something in the train station, or, I don't know, a 20-year-old guy was with an axe. I don't know.
Teenager shot to death after attacking passengers at train station in Germany.
Yes, the train station. Yeah, okay, I heard that.
Teenager died after attacking passengers, train station in Germany. Three people seriously injured after 17-year-old armed with axe.
Yeah, with
a knife.
Axe, yeah.
What the fuck was he thinking?
Yeah, I read that.
Bavaria, Islamic State flag found at home of suspect German train attacker.
Yeah, it was in Würzburg.
Teenager with armed knife attacked Bavarian and local police. Three people seriously injured. One person sustained light injuries before the attacker was shot to death by police. Police officer spoke to him, said Monday evening. Bavaria's
Interior Minister. Yeah, from Würzburg. Yeah, I've just been there.
Said 17. Afghanistan seeker, asylum seeker who arrived in Germany as unaccompanied minor and has been living with foster family in Ockenfurt, South Würzburg. Is that correct? Würzburg?
Yeah, that's what I meant. That's the city, and I've just been there visiting a friend in Würzburg. Yeah.
Wow. 14 passengers stayed in shock receiving treatment. Yeah, I'd be a little shocked if I saw someone get chopped with an axe in front of me.
Yeah, exactly.
Hello? I've seen people shot in front of me. That fucks
with
your head.
That's a normal American thing, to see someone shot, I think. But yeah, with an axe, that's...
Yeah, in America, we just cap people quick. We start shooting them with armed rifles and shit. 1.2 million refugees are living in Germany. By estimates right now, they're expecting it to increase to 3 million next year.
Mm-hmm.
That's more than doubling. Wow.
I know. Yeah.
It's
a big thing in Germany.
It's crazy going on right now.
I know. But what to do?
You have 200,000 Afghans trying to seek asylum there, and you guys are holding them up. They're not happy about it.
Yeah. But I think there's no other way to do it. We can't just stay at the border and...
Yeah, just put up a tent, have fun.
Well, people want to do it like this, but Yeah.
Everybody's freaking out about refugees from countries yeah, around the world. You're in America, in France, Germany. Everybody's like, whoa, whoa, what the fuck? Oh, you guys aren't all coming over here? Slow the fuck down. And they want to get out of there because everybody wants to kill each other there. And we're like, no, some of you might be killers. You'll have to stay at the border.
But here in America, it's not like that. So you don't take any refugees.
Oh, yes, we do.
Really?
Yeah, I think we took in 10,000 Syrians this year or more.
Okay. You 10,000 and we take...
a quarter of a million. Well, they're closer to you. It's a shorter ride.
And in it's Germany, longer, it's not even the
It's time. A longer bus yeah. to get here. It's called a plane or a boat. You're not just driving a car to come to America.
Yeah, right.
Not from Syria. Syria, they can just jump a little plane or take a little boat across. They can even drive around.
Yeah, right. That's the thing. Well...
You guys are much more convenient.
We have to be.
I guess.
I don't know. Yeah, that's why I'm moving now to America.
Well, and it's like, where is safe? I mean, we're getting people shot here at nightclubs.
Yeah.
That's why I've decided I'm going to travel for the next couple years. So if everything goes apeshit nut, at least I got my world travels in. And where I end up, who knows? But I'm not stuck here and I'm not stuck there because I'm traveling.
Yeah, but you're not sure that you're safe where you travel, so...
Oh, believe me, when I travel, I make sure I'm as safe as possible.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't travel stupidly.
But if you want to go to Turkey now, it's... I mean, in Turkey, I
know a lot of people in the Turkish government, and believe me, it'll be well cleared and there'll be paperwork done before I'm going to jump on a plane and just move there. Hell yes.
I mean, so many things are happening in Turkey as well. It's
true. Crazy. And that's why I said part of it will be done in Turkey. If it looks like a bad week, we'll go to India.
Yeah.
I'll just jump on a quick plane and get the fuck out of the country. Or I'll take a train into China. We'll go to China for a couple of weeks. It's time to shoot in China. Ah, we're going to see my friends in Thailand this week because it's not safe in Turkey.
Yeah.
You know, if I got to bop in and out, that's fine. Is it going to be safe for a couple weeks? Okay, we'll be back next month.
I believe you're so flexible here. Why not? It's good, it's good.
It's better to be flexible right now than be locked to a desk.
But you have 2 houses then in America, 2 fixed houses, one here and one in Michigan.
Yeah. Michigan will still be there. People in Michigan will stay.
Yeah.
I asked them if they wanted to go. They said, no, we're staying. I said, great. So the Michigan people can handle the operations of the U.S.
Yeah.
And I have people in L.A. who want to stay, so they'll stay here. But that doesn't mean I have to stay here. Because what people don't know here is that they wrote into law 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, that they can declare martial law here.
Okay.
Anytime the president decides he can make a martial law, he doesn't need an act of Congress anymore. Martial law means we become like Russia. The military comes in and seizes everything. Everybody starts signing lines for soup and bread kitchens.
Okay.
So I'm not sure I want to stay here. Now, if that does...